Hey, VaderMonkey's back. Right, I'm doing things a little bit different with this vlog. I'm doing a little bit of pre-intro, me gabbing and what have you, so I do apologise if you have to enjoy this look of pure enjoyment. Right, I just want to quickly just put out there, apologies for anyone that I may have pestered over the weekend. I had an idea of maybe talking to a few clubbers and a few DJs. Needs to say, I was enjoying myself a bit, not too much. I was enjoying myself in the point where it was like, it wouldn't have looked good on myself, and I didn't want to be wasting their time with me being a bit nervous or what have you. If I'm going to be doing any interviews or things like that, I want to be a little more confident, a little more sure, you know, sure of the questions and the feedback and the response. I mean, you could argue just having a, you know, just a simple down to earth conversation would have been better, and it wouldn't necessarily need to be a Q&A. But I had particular ideas, with it being a weekend and it also being a passion of mine, I had these ideas and they didn't come to fruition in the end. So for those that I may have not pestered, but sort of asked, but then kind of went back on the idea, I do apologise. It was just one of those. Secondly as well, it got to a point midway through the weekend where I was a bit obsessed with this whole vlog idea, and I needed to rein myself in a little bit and actually enjoy why I was there. So come Saturday, I was there with my friends. I ended up spending a lot more time with my friends over the weekend. I just want to thank John and Mish for having me. It's a chalet party, but having me play in memory of Ian Russell. God bless him. The guy was an absolute legend, not just of the scene, but of the whole hard dance community, really. He wasn't just confined to hard house. He came to some harder events. And John and Mish did a little, you know, commemorating thing. I think there was somebody else who bought something regarding his ashes as well. It was a lovely little thing to do. It was a lovely token gesture, and I'm glad to have been part of that. I'm going to get on with the vlog. So here's the footage that I got from over the weekend. All 3 days. I'll split them into 3 day segments. And enjoy.
Get me to do it. fresh eye, didn't get back to learn about 2017. Mind you, what did see first of time?
Okay, how was Tidyland? Fantastic weekender. Brilliant from start to finish. The people made it, the team made it, security even made it. It was a fantastic weekend. I thoroughly enjoyed it. And yeah, I'll be back for more. Anyway, the highlights for the weekender for me were Young Pulsar, Young Jay. If you want to see the future of Hard House, or future of just anything to do with Hard House music, then Young Jay is a talent that you cannot question. He's been going viral lately with a few things that he's been doing and faffing around. He's a credit to his parents. Kevin, his missus, just, you've brought up a little gem there. The young lad is definitely, I can't sing his praises enough. Also as well, JLF. Now, JLF works very, very hard. I've seen him about on the scene for the past couple of years. He is really putting the work, not just to promote his branding and to promote himself as a DJ, but he doesn't just walk the walk, he talks the talk as well. Tidyland was an absolute example of that. So for me, again, JLF, superb set, well played, and keep up the excellent work, young man. this cam. Now, this was the set of the weekender for me. I don't care what anyone else says or what anyone else thinks, right? The guy is so precise, clean, you know, methodical with how he just, you know, puts his sets together, you know, how he performs, the personality he gives off, and he did me in. Long and short, I've never stomped so bloody hard. It was me going in, going, right, it's Sunday, I'm going to take it easy, I'll have a wiggle to a few people, I'll enjoy the music, and then by the time his set came on, it was like, that went out the window. And yeah, all my ailments came to the fore come Monday morning, but it was well worth it. Excellent set, excellent work. Bit unfortunate he was on at the same time as the Tidy Boys for their Tony DeVee memorial set, which was a little bit disappointing. But then at the same time, you know, if you're going to go up against anyone, I suppose Tidy Boys is the yardstick, shall we say. So, yeah, superb sets, superb DJs. Right, purpose of this end bit of waffle that I do. My next gig, Jamfest, the glorified garden party or the micro festival, however you look at it, it's the best way to escape. Again, 72 hours from the world at Jamfest. They have Lisa Pinup, they have Jason Naughty, they have Digital Mafia playing, and plus a host of other talented DJs, which, honest to God, you wouldn't want to miss. I am planning on doing a little Q&A with them. I know I said at the start of this vlog that I wasn't very confident with doing it. John and Mish have reassured me that, look, you know, we'll take our time in doing it. There's no rush in getting it done. It will just take our time with it. So I want to do this little Q&A because I feel as though they deserve a bit of airtime and a lot of respect for what they're doing. You know, again, it's on a small scale. It's an intimate sort of festival, if you will, but the whole purpose and ethos of it is just, you can't question it, really. It's superb. They're fantastic people, and it'll be a fantastic event. Right, Trance Junkies. Originally, I was supposed to have done that on the same day as Filthface, but that got moved because of, one, clashes with other events, and as well that it's an upcoming trance event which deserves more support. I know with a lot of small brands, it's very hard for them to gain that support, gain that following. But again, for a day event in Retford, of all obscure places, it is an event to go to. It's something you don't want to miss. Dave and the team put a lot of hours and a lot of work into it, so I would recommend you do, you know, if you get time. There will be a Skiddle link for tickets. I would highly recommend you check it out and go and see what I'm on about, basically. So that's been now moved to the 2nd of September. The reason being, originally they penned it in for the 26th of August. Well, 26th of August is Greenfields weekend. You know, they would struggle with that, so they've moved it a week back. 2nd of September it is. 2nd of September, I recommend folk going at Retford for Trance Junkies. And although we could, I may be headlining, but yeah, there's other fantastic DJs on that lineup that are well worth your time and effort to see. So that's that. New Future Apparel. Now, if you have a dodgy uncle, is the right way of the word? Dodgy uncle, silly aunt, whichever, whatever. We're doing an introductory discount, 10%, with Intro 23 through our Etsy store with New Future Apparel. There's loads of tongue-in-cheek designs and stuff for DJs, stuff for clubbers and stuff like that. Stuff for your uncles, as I've already mentioned. And we are refreshing the lines because we will be creating children adolescent aimed clothesline as well back into this year. So if you keep an eye on our Etsy store, links and everything will be up here somewhere, then you know, you won't miss a beat with that. Right, Ableton Basic Starter Tuition. It's not affiliated with Ableton. It's just a basic, it can be a 10-week course if you choose it to be, but let's say we'll start with first 5 weeks. It's just learning 5 stages of how to get the best out of your VSTs, your plugins, and understanding the software. I understand a lot of people and a lot of producers even have sat around and spent countless hours just, you know, twiddling and going, oh, what does this do? What does this do? And then maybe a mate coming along and saying, oh, if you do that, do that, do that. And it's all about experimentation and learning. So I am running this basic course. The option of the extra 5 weeks is where you will be personally sat in the hot seat and you will be putting into action what you learned in the first 5 weeks. And it, the process is as if we're making a track, or at least the, you know, the foundations of a track, so to speak. And yeah, hopefully it'll benefit yourself. Okay, right. Neil Nultra album. The album's been out since 26th of May. It is selling, so before anyone goes, oh, it's not selling. It is selling. I just want to comment on the facts and support I've had so far. I'm happy that the people have taken this album a little more seriously. And I suppose my production to a point. In terms of myself regarding production, from September onwards, I'll be doing mostly collab work and engineering work. If you want to do any engineering projects with me, just get in contact. My email is jmiddletonmusic@gmail.com. And yeah, any future projects and stuff like that, I won't be doing anything off my own back for a while. I'm just doing a bit of experimentation and learning myself, so I'm in no rush to get back on the horse, so to speak, but I will be in the studio with others back into this year. Ultratech Dance Music, we've had, again, like the previous vlog, like I mentioned, we've had a very strong year with releases. I would love it to continue, so if you have anything that you want to get out there, we're still taking submissions. So email ultratechdancemusicuk@gmail.com, put it for the attention of Helen. She will have a listen, and if she needs a second opinion on it, obviously there's myself and there's other people within the Ultratech team that will listen, and we'll advise accordingly. If not, we'll sign it. Right, I just want to put thank yous into this. The reason for the thank yous is just basically the past few weeks. It's been beyond 100 mile an hour since the weekender, but I'll start with Tidyland. I want to thank the team at Tidyland, Andy, Ammo, Ben, Lee, Kim, Johnny Dangerous, everybody involved with the running of Tidyland weekender. You guys have absolutely smashed it out of the park. The previous weekend that I attended to, I was understandably disappointed, but obviously there's been a few weekenders between then and this one just gone, and you guys have definitely found a chemistry that works and a way to keep the faithful happy, and I commend you guys for it. I'm looking forward to the next weekender, whether you choose to do it next year or whether you take a year out, and I believe there's a 30th weekender event celebration on the horizon. So yeah, just whatever you guys choose to do, I'm fully on board, and I look forward to the next weekender whenever that happens. Keep up the work, keep it tidy, and yeah, thank you and well done. The other thank yous as well is the people that I spent the weekender with, that helped me kind of rein myself in a little bit, because good, honest, sincere people is worth its weight in gold. So, you know, come Saturday, I've got a little bit pre-obsessed with this vlog idea. I need to rein myself in and actually enjoy the weekender for what it was, enough for what I wanted to do. And yeah, I want to thank the people that I spent the weekend with, friends old and new. And just thank you for being you, and thank you for just helping me enjoy what was already a fantastic experience. Other thank yous is the DJs at Ultratech that have submitted work, the team at Ultratech. We are looking at expanding the team probably before the end of the year. With us having sub-labels, my workload now has got to the point where there's not enough hours in the day. So I am on the lookout for somebody to run the drum and bass sub-label, and somebody just kind of sit in with maybe Digital Simeon. We're not too sure yet. We are looking at that. We've already got somebody who we're taking on for the Ultratech White. We're looking to get more trance releases out for next year. So if you are a trance artist, aspiring trance artist or whatever, we are taking submissions for that. Email again, ultratechdancemusicuk@gmail.com. Please put it for the attention of Helen, and we will be in contact in due course. Okay, right, that's enough waffle. I've got another vlog to do. I've got a load of stuff to do. I look forward to seeing you guys at either Jamfest, Trance Junkies, and I just want to, actually, before I forget, mention about Tidy Warehouse on the 9th of September in Doncaster. I should have something up about that. All details will be on the tidytracks.co.uk, I think, website. But the tickets are through Skiddle, I believe. So if you want to go to that, fantastic lineup, can't miss it. And if you go, I'll see you there as well. Anyway, that's enough for me. Ciao bien, and see you next vlog. Bye.